And I'm still going to get it all wrong, particularly the beginning. So on behalf of ABBA, I'd like to welcome, and this is the first bit that's going to go wrong, the Right Worshipful, the Mayor of Lancaster, Richard Smith, the Curator, Professor Stephen Wildman, and honoured guests and artists. You might be interested to know that you are all here celebrating the preview of the Botanical Art Worldwide Exhibition in Ruskin's footsteps because of a wine-fueled supper between a couple of American and British botanical artists. Luckily, they woke up the next day, realising that this was a wonderful way of celebrating the Worldwide Day of Botanical Art in 2018. 25 countries thought the same, and together, for the first time ever, something amazing has happened. Native flora and botanical art has linked the world in peace. The slideshow with artworks from all these countries bear witness to this. And by the way, the slideshow here is the only one in this country that's got the Chinese one as well. The American Society of Botanical Artists, the ASBA, suggested the exhibition to its members. And a little over a year ago, we formed the Association of British Botanical Artists, ABBA, to put on the UK exhibition in Ruskin's footsteps. Each piece of artwork you see in this room is the result of many hours of preparation, a labour of love in researching the plant, sketching it with colour notes, then final painting or drawing. The botanical artists are from England and Wales, and they have subjected the results of their endeavours to huge scrutiny by experts in the field of botany and botanical art. These are the best of the best. When ABBA was trying to find a suitable place to hold the exhibition, we purposefully looked for somewhere north, away from London, where most things happen. Or so it is thought. Thanks to the vision of Professor Stephen Wildman and the approval of the Ruskin Foundation, we were initially offered a space to hold the exhibition in the Ruskin Library. However, as many of you are aware, the Ruskin Library has been closed for refurbishment, but thankfully, Lancaster University has honoured its agreement with us, with great help from Richard and the team at the Peter Scott Gallery. We are now able to show you the UK's contribution to the Botanical Art Worldwide Exhibition. Thank you, Lancaster University. I'll now hand over to Professor Stephen Wildman, who, as you now know, was the former curator for the Ruskin.
That's why I think what the artists here, if any of you are here, and the artists that you'll show you presented, are essentially doing very much what Ruskin was. So they're genuinely following in Ruskin's footsteps. It seems to be that what is happening here is pretty much what Ruskin would have approved of. I mean, looking carefully at a plant, examining it in its overall appearance, its detailed appearance, sometimes with its scale and its roots that will please the scientists, in other cases not, veering more towards art. Thousands, if not tens of thousands of drawings that he made, and I inherited the catalogue resume of Ruskin's drawings, which will certainly see me out, so many of them there are, were never intended really to be shown to anybody else, but they're intended to be used for his understanding so that he can write about the subject, but not intended as works of art, which is odd, which is why, just to conclude, that in many respects, I'm really in awe of the artist who can do this kind of work, which requires its patience, its skill, its knowledge, and its practical ability. Because I think, as a mere curator and occasional writer, I know that I can't do anything as well as Ruskin did. But for people, some of these drawings, and if you compare them with Ruskin's own, it is not an exaggeration to say that some of these, and the artists who are doing them, are better than Ruskin. And believe me, that is not something you can say very often. So to all the artists who have contributed to this marvellous exhibition, I would say congratulations. And if it needs to be opened, then I'm very happy to declare the exhibition.